Welcome to Real Estate Radio Live, an informative and engaging podcast discussing everything you need to know about the world of real estate. Your host, Joe Cacera, provides you with insight and guidance on how to buy, sell, finance, and invest in real estate. He also offers real estate tax management strategies, new construction advice, home improvement tips, and much, much more. And now, to guide you around the world of real estate, here's your host and Real Estate Radio Live team leader, Joe Cacera.
Welcome in, Joe Cacera with Real Estate Radio Live. Thank you for those that are following us on Facebook. We appreciate that very much. We want to continue to grow the audience and get as much information and education as we get to the consumer on a regular basis. This is a podcast. However, again, we do this live studio and also this broadcast so that we get as many people viewing the program and downloading. So if you haven't done so yet, if you're watching us on Facebook and you haven't downloaded the podcast, please do that at your convenience. We're with you. We do at least three shows a week on a variety of different topics, mostly in and around real estate. However, we've ventured out a little bit and we're doing some different shows that are catching some attention of those, and we want to continue to educate those consumers. So you go to iTunes, just type in Real Estate Radio Live, anywhere online really, and just type in Real Estate Radio Live. You'll see the podcast, download the podcast, share it with your friends, family, and coworkers if you will. So almost 8 years, I just want to remind those that might be tuning in for the first time or listening to the podcast for the first time, 8 years of doing the radio and podcast has been our focus, has really been the same, and that is to provide you, the consumer, with as much education and information around real estate as we can so that it helps you make wise decisions when you're really doing this. And so whether that's making a better decision on finding a partner, finding a real estate agent, lender, whatever revolves around your real estate, we'll continue to provide you with that information and have this value. So most of you know we've been doing for typically on Mondays, if everybody's schedule's in check. We've been doing a program now for, how long has it been, Mark, 6 or 7 months now?
Yes.
Yeah. Really to bring Mark and Steven from Barastone. Most of you have seen it if you've been following the show. The program, we're really excited about. It's getting a lot of traction. It's a equity share program, but Mark will speak to it in more detail. But it really, what it does is it gives you, the consumer, another option and an alternative to traditional financing, more importantly, reverse mortgage and some other things. So we'll get into detail about that, but it's a lot of education information, and we're excited about the program, so we hope that you'll get as much value in as most people have so far. If we get started, Mark, if you can just give the listeners a little overview of yourself, the company, and why this program is really, you know, getting a lot of traction in the industry, and then we could get started.
Well, thank you, Joe. I've been with Barastone. We started about 5 years ago, looking to help homeowners maximize their home wealth. We realize homeowners have built up a lot of equity in their home and are looking to get access to that equity. And we're really looking for alternatives to conventional mortgages, reverse mortgages, and really any debt product. Mm-hmm. And what we offer homeowners is a whole suite of products that are alternatives to debt. So homeowners typically can get up to 20% of their home's value without taking on any debt or giving up any of their existing equity. Homeowners do not have to make any payments since it's not a loan, there's no interest, mm-hmm. and homeowners agree to share the future appreciation or depreciation of the home, whichever occurs.
Perfect. So it's always a good idea. I like to go through quickly when we start the show on this program is to give you a frame of reference of the typical mortgage and the debt and the liabilities that most of us are used to. Real quickly, most of us are used to a traditional, you know, forward-paying mortgage. That means typically we'll purchase a home, we refinance, we put a loan on our home, and it could be a 30-year fix, 15-year fix, regardless. But the point is, you're paying on an interest rate that's leveraged and leaned against your home. So whatever that loan amount is, you go into an agreement with the lender and the investor, and you make monthly payments. And those monthly payments do not go away until you pay down that mortgage, whether it's 20 years from now, 30 years from now. That's a forward-moving mortgage. Most of them are very familiar with that. The other mortgage some of you may or may not be familiar with is the reverse mortgage. So the reverse mortgage is just what it says. If you meet a certain age criteria, if depending on the loan to value and some other factors, what happens is it's a Fannie Freddie product they'll give you this money, but it's a debt on your property. And then as you don't make any monthly payments, but keep in mind there is a monthly payment, in so to speak, that is going and adding to the principal. So I'll just give you a quick example. If you get a reverse mortgage for $300,000 or $400,000, and let's say in essence because of the interest rate, mortgage insurance is on the backside of that, it's $3,000 a month. That $3,000 a month just gets added to the principal balance of the loan every single month. So don't kid yourself in the sense that it's a very expensive, depending on the rate. They're adjustable typically. And again, there's a mortgage component, mortgage insurance component to that. The last one, or should say the other one some of you may be familiar with, is a home equity line of credit. It's a great program and product. If someone wants to use it for an emergency or they want to use it to, you know, maybe remodel their home, pay off debt, here's the problem. Though, home equity line of credit, when you access that money, there's a payment on it. There's an interest rate. There's a cost to that money. And so you have to make monthly payments on it. So if you use $200,000 to remodel or pay off student debt or do whatever, you have monthly payments on that. This program, you do not have monthly payments. There's no age requirement. So maybe, Mark, you could kind of take us through, unlike a reverse mortgage, I think you have to be 62 or older, right?
Correct.
There are some parameters around age. In other words, depending on your age, you could get more. Is that right? The older you get, you could potentially get more.
Right. With a reverse mortgage, the younger you are, the less money you can get, because it's based on life expectancy.
Right.
And if you're younger, they expect you to live longer. That's why when people look at reverse mortgages and they say it can eat away all of our equity, mm-hmm. it's because the reverse mortgage keeps getting larger and larger every year. And the older you are, the longer it's in place,
mm-hmm.
it could end up being a substantial amount that you owe. Elderly folks, 80, 90 years old, where your life expectancy isn't very long, you can get a lot more.
Right. Yeah, so unlike the program you're talking about, there's age requirement is what, 18, 21?
18. Legal age.
Legal age. No requirements for what you have to do with the money. You could use the money to start a business, pay off debt, remodel your home, anything like that.
Correct. So homeowners have used the proceeds for varied uses, everything from paying for college education, mm-hmm. paying off credit card debt, retirement, and supplemental income is a very large component of it. There's, as you said, no age requirement.
Right.
So the amount of money you get is truly based on the amount of equity you have mm-hmm. in the house, whether you're 19 years old or 90 years old,
right.
Same, you would be eligible for the same amount. And since the amount that you owe in the end is variable, it depends on if your house has increased in value or if your house has gone down in value. So it's tied to what happens with your house.
Got it.
So if your house goes down in value, there's a good chance you could owe less money back than you originally received because mm-hmm. the economics of the house has not been favorable.
Hmm. All right, very good. So what are you seeing mostly users across the board? I'll give some examples, too, that I live with every day, and I know you do, too. But what are you seeing people use this program with? What are you seeing, a percentage, or is it really across the board with a number of different options?
Well, there's a significant amount of people now that are seniors. We find a lot of people where it might be a husband and wife, and one of them is now at the stage where they need either in-home care or have to go live in a facility
okay.
where they need additional cash. And that's becoming a big issue mm-hmm. for the elderly senior citizens, is that in-home care and external facilities is very expensive.
Mm-hmm.
And our program can help them supplement that. And the good part is we can go on top of a conventional mortgage.
Mm-hmm.
So if the homeowner has a $300,000-$400,000 mortgage, maybe $100,000 HELOC, and they've now run out of cash, they can't put more debt on the property. They can't get a reverse mortgage because they have too much debt.
Mm-hmm.
Our product can go on top of that. And so that can free up another 20% of value of equity that they have and use that to supplement paying for those in-home care expenses, and a lot of homeowners really want to age in place.
Right.
And this helps them facilitate that.
Yeah, no, I would agree. So this is an example. I met with some clients yesterday. They came in. I've been helping their family with loans for, you know, 10, 12 years. And they're in the exact, almost the same thing Mark just described. So they came in to me yesterday. There's four family members. The mom is still in the home. Unfortunately, they have to. The dad is going into a full-time care facility, which is nearly $10,000 a month. I know it's hard to believe, but it is. It's real. I mean, if you're faced with this, these are real costs in the Bay Area. They really are. If you need 100% 24-hour care, you know, you need someone to watch over you, feed you, bathe you. I mean, there's a very expensive. And so they're now faced with, how do we get the money? How do we get this $8,000 to $10,000 a month? And who knows how long this gentleman's going to live? You don't know. And so these are hard things that people are faced with every single day. So in this case, their house is worth $2.5 million, and they're going to access the money from their home. Thank goodness, I was telling him yesterday, Mark, you know, at least they do have the home, right? Obviously, 40 years ago when they bought it, they were buying it to raise their family or whatever. No one really, you know, 40 years ago thinks, oh, this is great. My home's going to be worth this amount of money. But thank goodness, in this case, they have something that could help offset the cost for these people.
Yeah, that's the blessing in the Bay Area.
Right.
You know, homeowners have worked really hard to maintain their homes and pay for their homes. And now they have the opportunity mm-hmm. to let the home pay for their care.
Right. Yeah, and so there's many, many examples of what people are using this program for. Mark talked about this elderly stay in place as you age. I know that you've helped a lot of people paying off debt. Give us some examples of some of the people you've helped that way too, or consolidating.
Yeah, we had a homeowner a couple weeks ago that, you know, they have a conventional mortgage and a home equity loan on their property, but the husband got sick and couldn't work for about 4 or 5 months last year. And during that time, they didn't have enough cash to mm-hmm. maintain their lifestyle, so they use credit cards to supplement mm-hmm. that. And they find themselves now with $75,000 of credit card debt that they've built up over time. And they just can't make all the payments mm-hmm. and live. And our program, they're going to be able to access enough money to pay off those credit cards. They will get additional money that they will put in the bank, which we call comfort cash.
Mm-hmm.
And we've worked with them to look at a plan of 3 to 5 years to put the minimum payment that they were paying on their credit cards in savings,
okay.
save some additional money, and it's a 4 to 5 year plan that we've put in place for them to really be able to pay off our product mm-hmm. within 5 years, have their financial footing back on track, and just have their debt and then live their life accordingly. So that's a really great example of
yeah.
how our product is used to pay off credit card debt, which mm-hmm. they would be making monthly payments at. Some of their credit cards we looked at were 28%
yeah,
interest.
Crazy, isn't it?
It's amazing.
Yeah.
And at 28% interest, or, you know, we looked at the average. I think the average ended up at 19%.
Mm-hmm.
At 19%, that's a substantial payment every month. It's more than their mortgage and home equity loan. And we're able to wipe that out and put them on a plan to get
right.
their life back in order.
Yeah, no, that's a great example. The other thing I'm going to talk a little bit about with Mark, and I want to give some examples, is that what are your alternatives? And the reason I like to talk about alternatives is that what are the impact of these alternatives? I think it's important to really go through this exercise. So you need money, and where do you access this money, and what is the cost of this money, right? So follow me here. So if you take money from your home, traditional financing, remember, you're acquiring debt. You're going to have to service that debt and pay that debt, okay? Home equity line, same thing. Credit card, Mark just talked about, average 19%. And remember, 19%, most people, because they can't afford it, they just make the interest-only payments, and there is no end to that. That's the problem with that. So there's the other one. The other thing to keep in mind is, okay, where else? All right, retirement. What is the cost of accessing and liquidating your retirement funds? Depending if you're retirement age, you know, there could be penalties if you're not retirement age. And you may not want to take them that soon, right? I mean, Social Security, you may not want to collect. A lot of people will try to run that out as long as they can to really try to optimize that. Or you could sell your home, but I would caution you and you know, meet with a CPA, sit down and talk about what the ramifications of selling your home. It is absolutely unbelievable Mark, if you run through that exercise. You have a $2 million home that you've owned for 40 years, and you go to sell that, and let's assume it's a couple with a $500,000 exemption, right? So the rest of that is subjected to tax, big, heavy tax. We're not CPAs, but
We get a lot of referrals from CPAs because their clients come to them with a plan. The conventional wisdom has always been sell your house and downsize. And then the CPA goes through the math exercises of, you know, capital gains on the federal level, which is, you know, average 20% at, you know, once you cross a threshold. And then here in California, we have the 13% California tax, and then there's a 5% affordable care tax as well. And in a lot of cases, that can be upwards of 40 to 50% of the capital profit on the house after the $500,000. So in a lot of cases, as you said in your $2 million home example, it could be upwards of $500,000 to $700,000, depending on the homeowner's situation, that they pay in tax.
Mm-hmm.
And homeowners look at it and say, we don't want to pay that. And if you enter into a product like ours where they can use it to supplement their income and not have to sell the house, think about that on their heirs. They'd be saving $500,000 to $700,000 that they wouldn't have paid in tax if they can live in the house to their demise and the children inherit it at the full basis.
Right. So that's the really important thing to go through, too. So I would say that if you're listening to this podcast, it may not apply to you, but more likely than not, you, if you're listening to this podcast, you have a parent, grandparent, aunts, uncles, neighbors, some that I could guarantee you, if you look around or if you at least listen, no matter what age we are, we know someone that's in this predicament, just because the numbers bear it out. Their people are aging, the baby boomers are aging, and you have this play of what do you do and how do you manage your assets the best. And we just, that's why it's really important that we give you these examples of what Mark and I are doing, because the tax implications we talked about are very, very stiff. And then you looked at all the other options. My point here is that all the options that you have available to you, whether it be right or wrong, is it takes on liability, debt, and a cost. This program does not. You basically share in the future equity, but there's no monthly payments. There's no one going to be knocking at your door 2 years from now saying, you know, where's the payment? You owe us so much amount of money. I think, Mark, this is just really unconventional in some senses, and it's going to take people. I know it's gaining a lot of momentum over the last couple of years, but when, you know, let's face it, when we have 40, 50, 60 plus years of traditional, right, the way our minds think and our patterns and our, I mean, it takes people a little while to understand that this is something that's real and it's available.
Yes, these type of arrangements, equity share programs, have been around for many, many, many years. Typically, it's been done on a very, very small scale, family, friends, helping each other out. This has now been put into a structure and made, you know, commercialized. So investors are stepping in where family and friends, you know, only did it for their family. And now investors are doing it for everyone, so homeowners now can benefit across the board. So it's been around, but it's not been out in the mainstream, and that's what we're trying to do, is to get the awareness out there that there are programs that are loan and reverse mortgage alternatives that can help homeowners maximize their home wealth and really understand how to manage that home wealth.
Yeah. If someone's, as they listen to the show now or as they download it later, what's the best way to contact you to find out a little more information if they have questions for you, or maybe a parent, grandparent, or relative needs some help with that?
Sure. They can either access us on our website at barastone.com, B-A-R-A-S-T-O-N-E.com, or if they want to call, we'd be more than happy to talk to them. Our phone number is 650-802-0800.
Right. Let's just kind of go through some examples. I think it's always good to let people, to really let it resonate that they could do anything they want with this money. We talked about the age requirements. You talked about paying off debt, high credit card debt. We see it all the time. You could pay off a current mortgage, right? If you have a $200,000 mortgage, your home's worth $2 million, just give us examples. and someone wanted to pay that mortgage off and maybe a little bit more money, depending on the loan to value, they could do something like that?
Absolutely.
Okay.
And we see a more common is they have a conventional mortgage,
mm-hmm.
and then they took out a
home equity line. Right.
And that might have been 10 years ago. It's coming due.
Right.
They can't qualify to refinance the whole house, or they just don't want
right.
that debt. We can pay off that home equity loan or, as you said, the conventional mortgage to mm-hmm. eliminate their debt.
Right. Yeah, Mark made a good point, and I want to bring this up. Just most of you keep in mind on these home equity loans, again, they're great programs. A lot of people say, hey, Joe, I'd love to have them on as an emergency. And I mean, that's true. Those are a lot of good reasons to have access to money. I think we all would agree that. Just in case something happens, it's great to have access to money so you don't have to liquidate something, right? That's true, especially if you're younger. But on the home equity lines, remember, what happens is those programs run for 10 years, and a lot of people forget. So if you're carrying a balance, it looks really great when you have $200,000-$300,000 and your payment's $300 or $400 or $500 a month. You think, God, this is pretty sweet. You know, it's not a bad deal. When that 10 years is up and it recasts, a lot of people forget about this, it'll recast and not only drop down to a 20-year amortized loan, but it goes to a principal and interest loan based on the current market rate. Just for an example, I've seen payments, Mark, go up 3-4 times what they are. So if you had a $500 payment, it could go to $1,500 to $1,600 a month.
We had a client last week that they're going to be using our product to pay off. They have $150,000 home equity mm-hmm. loan, and their payment was around $400 or $500
yeah.
for interest only, and their new payment was going up to about $1,700,
yeah.
and they can't afford that. So we're going to be able to pay off that home equity loan, put some extra cash in the bank for
mm-hmm.
emergencies, and they are really ecstatic about that.
Yeah. The other thing I want to bring up that I see a lot in the residential financing is about 30%, roughly, this is quite a bit in the last couple of years, 30% roughly of the purchases that we do, there are some kind of gift funds helping people with these purchases, typically young homeowners, first-time home buyers, typically. And so the reason I bring this up is if you're a parent or a grandparent and you've thought, geez, you know, I'd love to have my kids stay around or I'd love to have them stay here, it's awfully expensive. How do they afford a 20% down payment on a $1 million home? We're all faced with those if we have children. Keep in mind, you could access this program. You could access capital from your home and do gift funds. You could help your children, your grandchildren with gift funds, Mark. I mean, it's another good idea, right?
Absolutely. We see that more and more. Homeowners, you know, and myself included, you look at your children are
mm-hmm.
now of age and they're looking at potentially moving out of the Bay Area because of the housing prices
right.
have been so expensive. We have many homeowners now that have looked at our product to use to give their children basically what they would inherit in the future because it's not anything of the current,
mm-hmm.
it's of the future. So on a typical $2 million house, we have one homeowner that has two children and he's offered them each $200,000 for the down payment to buy a house in this area. He has one child who's now going to use it, so he's going to do the product, and he has one that's looking for a house, and he's ecstatic because he sees both kids going to stay in
mm-hmm.
the Bay Area and use it to buy a house.
Yeah, that's great examples. Just a couple minutes before we finish up here today, again, for more information on this, you can go to RERadiolive.com. You could follow the show. Best thing to do is download the podcast. We'll continue to bring this information to you. But, again, I'll have to stress, if you're listening to this, don't be afraid to pass it along to parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, coworkers, whoever you think might be in a position where they're needing money like this. I could tell you that I don't know what the number is, but I do know that the number is large. What I mean by that is the amount of people that are aging in the situation like the story that I discussed today and the one that Mark talked about and the one we always give examples, those are real, especially in the Bay Area. They're real. So we want to be able to help people and give them as much as options as we can. So before we leave again, Mark, let those know how they could reach you.
Yes, they can go to our website, which we have some information on how the programs work at barastone.com. That's Barastone.com. And we're always happy to chat with homeowners to help them explain how the program works and talk about how they can maximize their home wealth. And they can call us at 650-802-0800.
Very good. All right, we're going to cut out. Mark, thanks for your time. It's always good to be with you.
Thanks, Joe.
Great program. For more information, again, you could always go to reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. For those that would like to reach out during the week, I get emails, texts from time to time. Don't be afraid to do that. We're here to answer any questions about anything related to real estate. You can reach out to me, Joe, at reradiolive.com, or you can always text 408-838-9060. Take care. Have a great afternoon.
You've been listening to Real Estate Radio Live. For more information on today's program, visit reradiolive.com. That's reradiolive.com. Subscribe to our podcast. Discover more at reradiolive.com.